Greetings and welcome to Pro Guitar Shop. My name is Brett Kingman. I'm coming to you from the sunny climes of Melbourne, Australia, and I am very proud to present to you the brand new Tech 21 Bass Fly Rig. This is dedicated to bass players, although I guess guitar players could use it. It has a number of additions on top of those features that were found on the guitar versions, namely a balanced XLR output as well as a quarter inch unbalanced output. We've got a compressor on board here, we've got a pad switch here, we've got a pre and post boost switch here, and we've got the octave and fuzz, or the octave filter as they like to call it, as well as an onboard tuner and as well as a chorus. This is a Sterling by Music Man Ray 34. It's a fine bass and it's running directly to Pro Tools via the bass fly rig, and it sounds like this with absolutely nothing else on it. I'm not much of a finger player, so I'm going to use a pick mainly, but the first thing we need to look at is the Sansamp, and the Sansamp will take you through a range of different amplifiers thanks to the character knob here, from early 70s kind of big thud machines up to much more gritty affairs. There's a three band EQ, high, mid and low, and each of those is plus or minus 12 dB active, so they're quite sensitive. Let's start with the character knob at around 10 o'clock. Nice deep sound. As we wind it up, it gets a little more grittier. Perhaps reminiscent of classic studio sounds. By the way, all of the EQs on this Ray 34 are completely flat at the moment. When we wind the character knob up even more, you start to get a biting mid-range. Now you can actually accentuate that by winding it up even further. Or keeping it down at around, you know, the Goldilocks level, which is about noon, and using the drive to inject more filth. So, for instance, if I was going for like an old Ampeg tone, I would probably leave that drive where it is, back the character knob off a bit, and maybe up the lows. And you can tell the low is pretty damn sensitive. The mid control, likewise. Also the high control, which I've had up, wound pretty high. Then you've got a little bite nipple knob here, which will inject more presence. Boost you can have before or after, or extra level, or extra drive. The compressor is a classic old school FET compressor, or FET compressor. With its own tone control, so you can wind in those tops that sometimes get lost with compressors. It also has its own level control, and you can wind it right up to get squishy. Cool, huh? Then we come to the octave filter, and we've got a choice of octave or fuzz or both. that's in octave mode at the moment. If I hit fuzz mode, wind the mix control up and the range, which is like the frequency range. You've got a Q control here to broaden or sharpen the bandwidth of the filter. Turn the boost off, turn the compressor on. That's going to actually turn it into almost a synth because these notes are going to hang forever. Octave and fuzz. I could spend an entire demo just demoing the octave filter because it's capable of a lot. I encourage you to do the same when you get your hands on one. Next to it is a little headphone nipple knob here, and it applies to the quarter inch output on the back. It'll give you a lot more level so you can use the fly rig with headphones. I would recommend having it out when you plug it into the desk, or you're going to get a lot of signal. XLR ground switch next to it. And then this quite beautiful chorus pedal. With just one simple knob that you can use to adjust the depth. There's a little bit of delay time between the dry and the wet. Is around 13 inches long. It weighs about 20 ounces or 560 grams in the metric language. That means you can throw it into your gig bag or your case. It's going to save you a lot of hassles. It's going to save your back. It's going to save you turning up to a backline situation where you don't know whether the amp's going to be great or not. It will do everything. There's a plethora of different amp sounds in there thanks to the character knob and the Sansamp. If you like, you can run it straight into the front end of any amp. I'd recommend it running into a clean amp. Then you won't get so much adulteration with the Sansamp. The other plus of it is there's a tuner on board, and you access it by holding down the chorus knob here, and you've got... It's telling me I need to tune up. I'm not a great bass player, you all know that, but I know great bass sounds when I hear them, and they're all in here, in this tiny little bass fly rig, which is going to save a lot of butts, and should probably just be bought to have on hand at all times. This one's not leaving. See you soon. Thanks for watching.